Hi folks, this is René for GNS Threefold, and in this video I'm going to show you how to solve the access list logging lab. So I got two routers and we are running OSPF, and on one of these routers I'm going to create an access list only for logging. So let me show you how to do this. Okay, so router scout, we're going to log all the OSPF packets. So let's go to router scout and let me boot up my routers here. Here we go. So what I can do here on router scout is, first of all, I can create let's start with the access list. So let's create IP access list extended. Let's call it OSPF log. Permit, I'm gonna do OSPF, any, there we go. Go to the interface, and that's where we will enable it, inbound. Here we go. Okay, so this is just a normal access list. You can see that I have a match already, but what I should do is, so permit OSPF any, what I should do is add this line log, and we can also choose for logging including the input interface. So let's do a log input here. Show access list, and you can see that it just added the statement, so I need to get rid of the first statement. So one more time, node 10, show access list, and here it is. Here we go. So you can see it's already working. So OSPF permitted this packet, fast Ethernet, and you can also see the MAC address, and the destination is the multicast address. So far so good. One more thing, your log file should be updated every 4 seconds. Now that's something you can change if you like. So what we can do is say IP access list question mark. You can see there's an option here for logging and for log update, and I need log update and change the threshold to what you can do over here is the number of hits. So is that what I'm looking for? Yeah, should be updated every 4 packets. So if I set it to 4, and it will be updated every 4 packets. You can also use logging. You can change the interval here for logging if you like. I don't have a lot of traffic right now, but if you have a lot of traffic, you might want to change the logging interval, or you'll be flooded with logging information. Okay, so I did this, I changed the threshold, and the last step, you can see it says make sure you log the MAC address, and I did this by using the log input. So let me show you the access list one more time. By using this keyword, log input, it will also log the input interface. And that's why you see the MAC address over here. You can see the fast Ethernet interface, and you can see the MAC address. So that's it, that's the end of this lab. It's a fairly simple example of how you can use access lists for logging information. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and till next time.